Human interfaces to computers are essential. This video will focus on our hands inputting data and a microcontroller replacing hands for automatic data logging. I will show you five very different projects and maybe you find a project idea for this summer. Greetings YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent with a new episode and fresh ideas around sensors and microcontrollers. Remember, if you subscribe, you will always sit in the first row. In PC lingo, mice, keyboards and similar devices are called human interface devices, short HID. They either input or output data from and to humans. This video will focus on input devices. So the five projects focus on the following topics. How can we connect keys, rotary encoders, joysticks, potentiometers, etc. to our PC? We will connect them as keyboards and as mice, and use USB and Bluetooth. We will use different hardware and I will show you which works and which not. And finally, you should get some inspiration for your own projects. Let's get started. The HID protocol is defined between a host and a device. The hosts usually are PCs or smartphones. The devices are microcontrollers connected to physical devices like keyboards or mice. You see all HID devices connected to your PC when you go to the device manager. Here you also see that you can have several similar devices connected to one PC. They usually work in parallel. This is particularly important for the following warning. Because HID devices can press keys in parallel to your keyboard or move the mouse without your intervention, your sketch can screw up your computer if something goes wrong. So always program a stop switch into your sketch for debugging. Without such a switch, you never get control over your PC back until you unplug the USB cable of your project or, if you use Bluetooth, switch your device off. Enough warning. How can we build such a device? We basically have two possibilities. Either we use a USB cable or Bluetooth for a wireless connection. If we want to use a USB cable, we have to use an Arduino with an ATmega32U4 chip, like the Arduino Pro Micro or Leonardo, or a very special device called Rubber Ducky. From the cheap Arduinos, only the ATmega32U4 offers an onboard USB connection. Nearly. Some older projects used the 16U2 chip of the Arduinos for that purpose. I do not recommend this route. Why? First, most of the knockoff Arduinos do no more use the 16U2 as a USB to serial converter, and second, it is a pain in the da-da-da to program it. So I strongly suggest to sticking to the Arduino Pro Micro. Enough theory, let's do project number one. Here is my new Microscope camera. It has to be operated with a mouse. Which is, of course, nonsense. Because your attention is on the object and you need your hands to position the goods below the lens. In my opinion, such a device has to be operated by buttons or even better, a foot switch. But how can we get this done? We have to emulate all needed mouse movements and map them to buttons. That video profoundly inspired this project. However, I wrote a simpler code because I only wanted four keys. Auto and manual focus, immediate focus, and take a picture to the SD card. If we look at the screen, we see the movements the mouse has to make to reach the requested buttons, and we can take some notes. I use the example shoot a picture. Here we have to move the mouse to this place and click. The sketch to create the same results is simple. We use the mouse.h library, set up four pins as inputs for the buttons, and in the loop we pull all keys and if one is pressed, we move the mouse pointer to the imaginary place using commands issued by our sketch. As we saw before, take a picture means we go to the left top corner to open the menu. Now we go right and down. Because the pointer has to travel more than 127 steps, we have to cut this down movement into two parts. Then we click and leave the menu. I added a delay to avoid a too fast re-triggering. This line is important for testing on the PC. If you define life and press a button, commands are sent to your PC and your mouse pointer moves because your device is connected to its USB. I only uncomment life when I want to test the device on the camera. I think this is a cool project, and this idea can be used for other instruments where you want to reduce complexity or add a foot switch, for example. I will see if I later add such a foot switch in parallel to the button. Project number 2 also uses a USB connection and is for data logging. In video number 9, I showed how you could log your data directly into an application like Excel by emulating a keyboard with an Arduino Pro Micro. There, the Arduino measured current and voltage and keyed the result directly into Excel. Such a project can be useful for many purposes. As in video number 9, you find many interesting other topics in the 343 videos on this channel. Maybe an idea for binge watching on a lazy summer evening while learning something useful? Just one thing. Do not complain about the speed of my voiceover of the early videos. Concentrate on the content. Project number 3 is an emulation of an insanely expensive keyboard for video editing. I'm no professional producer and do not need such a quality stuff. But I would like to have some of its features, like a wheel and a few additional buttons. I just began with the project and we can use it to learn how to create a Bluetooth keyboard with an ESP32. We could also create such a Bluetooth HID device by using a standard Arduino and a hacked HC-05 module. Too complicated for me. Building a Bluetooth HID device with an ESP32 is a piece of cake. But first, what do I want? I bought this rotary encoder made for CNC machines. It feels like high quality and can be moved in tiny but defined steps. The only thing I miss for this application is that it does not move freely. This one stops immediately when you leave it. So, if you have a link for a high quality chalk wheel that runs freely and is affordable, please leave a link in the comments. Anyway, this chalk wheel behaves like a standard rotary encoder and, connected to 5 volts, it produces two quadrature signals which can be read by a standard library. Let's have a look at the sketch. We use the BLE keyboard.h and the ESP32 encoder.h libraries. In setup, we have to initialize the Bluetooth keyboard and the rotary encoder. The rotary encoder has to be initialized with a attach single edge to produce one event per smallest movement. Other rotary encoders may have to be initialized with a attach half quad or even with attach full quad. Best you try it out. In addition, we initialize a button to change the scrolling speed between fast and slow. Then we initialize the keyboard. After this command, we should see our ESP32 in the Bluetooth setup screen of the PC or the smartphone. Be aware, you only can connect it to one device at a time. You have to disconnect it before you can reconnect it to another device. In loop, we read the jog wheel. The function read jog wheel decided if the wheel is turned to the left or the right. Depending on the direction, we want to send a left or right arrow to the PC. From where do we know the names of the different keys? First, all letters and numbers can be written as a character. And the special keys are found in the blekeyboard.h in the library folder. To show you another specialty, I want to move the cursor faster if the chalk button is pressed. My video editor DaVinci Resolve wants a Shift J to move fast to the left and Shift L for fast right. This is done by letting the sketch press P left shift and J together. Then we wait for 100 milliseconds and release all keys. Of course, this project needs a lot of additional work. but maybe you also have similar applications in your field. For example, to steer your SDR radio or your CNC, please comment. Project number 4 is with smartphones. If you couple your ESP32 with a smartphone, you can remote control it. For example, you can increase or decrease the volume. Already something. But because the same buttons can be used in the camera app to take a photo, you can build a remote activation for your smartphone. For example, you could use your old smartphone for a photo booth at a party. Or we could create a lab photo booth for Dishka. Here I would just need a microphone attached to the ESP32 for the trigger. By the way, this sketch works with iPhones and Androids. I'm sure you can also remote control many other functions if you find the codes. Maybe somebody knows a link to a compilation? I leave both code snippets on GitHub. If you have cool applications, you can create a pull request and I will include your code there. Instead of using a few buttons, you can also add a keypad or create your own one using such buttons. Project number 5 has two faces, a good one and a bad one. It is called Rubber Ducky. It seems Darren from Hack5 invented the term, and it stands for a USB stick that contains a MCU instead of storage. If you insert it to your PC, it starts to inject keystrokes as we did in all previous projects. The only difference, it can inject good or bad commands. Because you are logged in, this nasty thing can, for example, install a backdoor to spy on you. Of course, it can also do good things. Here I have such a device. It does not resemble a USB stick because I did not buy it for this purpose. It is basically an Arduino Pro Micro with a reduced number of I/O pins. Theoretically, we could have used it also for our earlier projects. I used the project Overthruster to create a script that downloads a file from the internet as soon as the device is inserted into a USB connector. You see, this script runs in the foreground, and you see what it does. Of course, you could also create one users do not see. Overthruster creates a standard Arduino sketch that can be uploaded to either such a Rubber Ducky or a Pro Micro. I do not want to go more into detail. The bad guys already know this stuff. The good guys find the information in the links in the description, and the rest of us know that it is probably better not to insert an unknown USB device to our computers. These were the 5 projects. Summarized, we used the Pro Micro and its smaller brother to create projects using USB. We were able to connect not only buttons but also wheels and potentiometers to our PC. In the next 2 projects, we used Bluetooth instead of USB to connect our devices. Using this technology, we were also able to connect to smartphones and switch volume or take a picture. The last project with its 2 sides showed us also the dark side of the technology and showed us how rubber duckies work and how we could protect ourselves from their attacks. As always, you find the relevant links in the description. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. If true, please consider supporting the channel to secure its future existence. Thank you. Have a nice summer. Bye.